As American industry matured, the primitive concept of unrestrained competition was perceived to be less than a blessing. Monopolies of the sort enjoyed by the Camden and Amboy barons looked far more soothing to the nerves and beneficial to the wallet. The answer was the trust, a combination that organized groups of companies in a single industry into a monolith that set wages and prices. A nationwide revolt against these tactics began in the late 1880s. State after state passed antitrust laws.
But New Jersey once more displayed its talent for marching to its own special drum. It not only refused to pass an antitrust law, it authorized holding corporations, giant combines, uniquely suited to issuing large amounts of common stock, which simplified the takeover of other companies.
Standard Oil absorbed the oil industry for John D. Rockefeller under the generous provisions of New Jersey's laws. Hundreds of other corporations rushed to imitate the performance. The costs were modest. All that was needed was a one-room home office and a few pieces of paper from the state, purchased for 20 cents on each $1,000 of capitalization.
The big jolt to New Jersey's bosses and their business backers came from the most unexpected place in the most unexpected way.
In 1901, a young Irish Catholic undertaker named Mark Fagan ran for mayor of Jersey City on the Republican ticket. Jersey City was governed by an unsavory alliance between E.F.C. Young, president of the First National Bank, and Little Bob Davis, the Democratic boss. Running against bossism and in favor of such basic services as efficient police and fire protection, Fagan stunned the city and the state by beating the Democratic boss and his banker partner. With the assistance of Corporation Counsel George L. Record, Fagan submitted to the legislature a program proposing equal taxation and a limitation on public utilities. The legislature ignored him. The infuriated Fagan responded with an open letter of protest against corporation control of the Republican Party.
This bombshell exploded across the state with startling effects. It launched the New Idea movement, which soon attracted outspoken and independent Republicans. The success of Fagan and Record in Jersey City inspired dozens of other Republicans and Democrats to join the New Idea movement, which soon blossomed into the New Jersey version of the progressive movement.
But the New Idea men were promising more than they could deliver. In the primary elections of 1906, Republican regulars routed the New Idea men everywhere.
In 1910, with the leaders of the New Idea beaten to the political sidelines, the Republicans decided they could go back to a safe, conservative governor. Democratic bosses were thinking along the same lines.
James Smith of Essex and Robert Davis of Hudson decided they would be happy with a college president named Woodrow Wilson. Wilson was not just any college president. He was president of Princeton. There he had led a widely publicized fight for curriculum reform and the abolition of the aristocratic eating clubs. Wilson had been defeated by alumni conservatives, but he had won a national reputation in the process. Over fervent protests from progressives, Smith bludgeoned the state convention into accepting Wilson as the Democratic candidate for governor.